Without further ado, let me introduce the first speaker, which is Hal Tedroff, one of our more recent graduates from the department. He graduated in May of last year with a BA and took a position with the Wendy's Corporation. He tells me he has nothing to do with French fries or hamburgers, but he is in fact a development specialist, and I will let Hal tell you more about what he does. So please join me in welcoming Hal.
Well, I'm Hal, and I work for the Wendy's Company, and I've been there for a couple of years now. I'm a development specialist, and in the most vague sense, that pretty much means I'm a project manager for development of new restaurants, and that is on the company and the franchise side, all the way from, hey, we're investigating this site, we want to take a look at it, to getting it open. So I track and manage pretty much the entire process from start to finish. There are a lot of skills that I learned as a history major that proved very useful in the business field, and hopefully you guys are all learning those exact same skills as well. So what's kind of interesting in my team, there are six of us who work in the West Territory developing restaurants, and three of us have an undergrad of history, my boss and then one of the other directors. So the skills that we learned as undergrads in history have really translated very well into the business world. I think the number one skill that I use every day that I honed as a history major would be communication. The ability to transfer knowledge and data and information to a bunch of people. And something that I learned as an undergrad in history was how to transfer that knowledge to people who may be experts or people who know nothing of what you're talking about through various mediums. Speaking is one of them. And then writing, we have really good writing skills. We've got to pay attention to details. We also use mediums like email and talking over the phone or creating a PowerPoint or a video. These are things that I do every day or week or month at work. And I honed those skills here. I think another great thing that is useful that history majors have as far as a skill set goes is data analysis and interpretation. So when I'm looking at a site that we may choose to build a restaurant, I'm looking at the demographics. Who lives there? How many people live there? How many people are there during the day? Is it residential population? What's the traffic count? How many cars are going past? You need a big base of people to support a Wendy's restaurant. So taking that and boiling that down into, yeah, we've got enough people, you know, traffic count looks good, and then is the site good? Can people see the site? And making that a decision, yes or no, is something that I think history majors are extremely good at, taking a bunch of data and boiling it down into one idea and making a decision with that idea. So critical thinking. Strong writing skills come into play when I'm communicating, which is with 1,000 people all the time, via email. It's really important to convey the right idea to the right people. Beyond that, there are several sites where the company either holds interest or the company is building a restaurant where I have to make a package that tells my executive board, the CEO, the CFO, the COO, why we think this is a good site. And not only having data, raw numbers to look at, you know, that proves to them that this is a good site, but being able to tell a story to them as to why this would make a good restaurant is another wonderful skill that translates very well from history into business. So history, you know, is extremely broad, business is extremely broad, and I think the skill sets between the two are very, very compatible.
Thank you. You will all have a chance to talk informally one-to-one with all of the speakers after the program, but I think we have plenty of time to entertain a few questions for Hal, if you have any.
Yeah. How did you make the transition from graduating or even, and you mentioned that you have been with Wendy's for several years, so how did you make your transition from your degree into your career, and did you find any difficulty in making that transition?
Sure. So the transition was completely seamless. I applied to the position, interviewed, and was accepted based on the skills that I was communicating to them that I possessed as a history major. One of the things I think I may have glossed over is working individually and working on a team are things you're going to be doing a lot in the future, and having that ability. So I know sometimes we don't like working with other people, right? Like, you never know who's going to show up or pull their weight. So knowing your role, knowing how you can execute your area of expertise and contribute to your team is extremely important. Also having the discipline to work independently. But no, the transition was completely seamless, and the skills that I possessed as an undergrad of history transferred perfectly.
Other questions?
Sure. Did you like pursue any internships like while you were in undergrad, or like clubs or activities that you really like thought stood out when you were applying?
I think the number one thing would be my internship with the Ohio History Center. I worked in the visitor studies department, so there was a lot of communication involved between individuals. So some days I would literally just go stand on the floor and talk to whoever walked in. And if there was a cabinet that we were using there, I won't go into like loads of detail, but there was a cabinet they were using there where they put a bunch of objects with no, aside from the fact that it was a display in the kitchens, which I think it's still there, section, no descriptions whatsoever of what it was. And a lot of them are really funky, odd things that you haven't seen, probably because they're 100, 150 years old. So we would get into a conversation about those objects. So some of the people who came in were experts. They collect antiques. Some of those people knew nothing of that, and being able to communicate with people who know a bunch about something or know nothing, who are curious, I would say that was an asset. Yeah.
Sure.
What would you say is the biggest difference between a private enterprise mindset and a public mindset? And how did you account for that when you made the switch?
We have shareholders. So you're pleasing a lot more than just your boss or yourself or the individuals who you work the closest with. At the end of the day, we have people who invest in the company, and you have to have there's a whole lot more going on than just right here kind of mindset.
Can I ask a quick question?
Sure, yes.
So you didn't do an MBA or any kind of formal business studying. From now that you're an insider, as it were, in that whole world of high corporate activity, how valuable or necessary is it to have an MBA if one were to desire to have the kind of career you have, which would seem to be like one that an MBA could be useful for?
Yeah.
What would be your view of an MBA? Is it necessary or valuable to have it?
Well, so my boss and virtually everyone on my team does have an MBA. Mm. And there are a few people my age who are working in a similar role who have their MBAs. I am probably the least educated person on my team. So I'll use that to my advantage. I think an MBA is helpful for loads of reasons, but I don't think it's absolutely crucial if you already possess quite a number of the skills that you would learn with an MBA. The MBA might take you to the next level. I'm confident that it would do that. But I think where I'm at, the role that I possess, looking at those around me who do possess an MBA, we share the exact same skills. They may have a slightly nuanced kind of approach. Everything else is pretty flat.
Are you involved in hiring at all?
I was for a period of time involved in recruiting new franchisees, and I was the very first line of defense in that process. So when someone came in, usually it was via email or phone call asking pretty much, hey, can I be a franchisee? I was the first round of vetting, trying to figure out what experience they had, if they were financially capable of purchasing or building a restaurant, which is a really expensive thing to do, And pretty much it boiled down to, do you have the money and do you have a colossal amount of operations experience in working in restaurants? And if you didn't make it past me, you weren't going to see our actual recruiter. So that would be the extent of the hiring experience.
But if there were hiring on going on in Wendy's for people like yourself, how large would an MBA loom on their horizons, as it were? How much are they actively looking for that, or is it just something that's almost incidental?
So I'm going to say, based on who we have hired and the fact that most of them, especially the individuals who are my age, under 30 or about 30, either all possess law degrees or MBAs, I'd say it's something we hold very valuable.
But it's not anything specific in the training as such. It's more like that these are people, you know, with refined general skill sets rather than specific skill sets.
Typically, we have hired people who have zero experience in what they're doing. We do tend to hire people who have franchise experience. It doesn't have to be with another restaurant company, but there are franchises of loads of different things. So it really depends on who we find to be the best. Yes?
What would you like to be doing in 5 years?
That is a really good question, and I'm still trying to figure that out. I do miss history. I miss researching. When I was an undergrad, I really thought, yeah, let's go do a PhD, that'd be super. And then I looked at like what that looks like, and it was kind of horrifying, because I couldn't narrow it down to one single thing that I wanted to study. I got into history because I wanted to learn everything about everything. And it's so massively broad that you can do that. If you have an interest in something and you study history, you can just go there. So 5 years from now, I'm not sure. I wouldn't hate if I was still with the Wendy's company. I do like my job and I like the company. I'm not being paid to say that. but that's a good question that I don't have an answer for.